part three. So I don't know if these are cutting out or not, but one of the other issues that one of the other things that I heard a lot about is formal specifications. So this whole idea of giving the developers who are working on the Cardano project the guidelines or the dictionary to create whatever they're creating within this ecosystem. And that's basically what formal specifications mean, you know, like the idea of having that high level theoretical paper, and translating it into a guide of how to build this cryptocurrency project. So people are always ragging on Cardano for just releasing papers, but the papers are important, because if the theory is solid and the idea is peer reviewed and it has been accepted, then that means that more than likely the actual code, if you translate that paper into code, it's going to be secure and it's going to allow people to transact within this ecosystem without having worries about, you know, them losing money or them their smart contracts not deploying correctly. And you know, that's an issue that's going to be faced by a lot of different cryptocurrency projects out there, but not Cardano. So one of the other things that I wanted to talk about was this idea of Charles, when he spoke, about Plutus, he said that his goal, he's going to be training 10,000 Plutus developers, which is staggering. So these are going to be the 10,000 developers, it's starting at 10,000, that are going to transform this ecosystem into probably the most powerful smart contract blockchain in the world. And, you know, the goals, there were so many developers there that were just trying to learn and they looked so excited. You know, I could understand, I don't understand the code, but I could feel the level of excitement and the anticipation for this to release. People are looking for solutions. Even Ethereum developers, they want to leave the system. They want to do something. They want to build on a system that is a little bit more secure, that is a little bit more friendly for them and allows them to have greater flexibility. And I think that once this releases, Cardano is going to be huge. I mean, just in terms of people developers developing. And you know, one of the bullet points on the like one pager that they put was this idea that in-house developers can now leave basic smart contract development to domain experts. So, you know, how does this translate to business solutions? The idea that the complex code is being written by Cardano and the simple code is going to be written by, or the simple contracting, the simple way you're going to create your smart contract will be determined by the institution building their smart contract on top of the platform. So Bank of America or Wells Fargo or Bank A or Bank B or Car Company A, Car Company B, they want to build a smart contract on top of Cardano. They don't need to hire expensive Haskell developers, or they don't need to hire expensive Solidity developers that are only versed in one particular language to build their smart contracts. Whatever developer that they have on site, they'll be able to do it with relative ease, because that's what Marlowe's going to allow, that relative ease of just plugging and playing. I want this to deploy every Tuesday. I want 50 ADA to go towards this smart contract and reach my customers, or do this, do that, whatever use case that they have, they're going to be able to build it correctly. So let me know what you think. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and until the next video.